Hey guys, it's Weston with Outside Science, Inside Parks. In this episode, we get an insider's look into Project C.A.V.E.S, a cool cave camp in Arkansas that lets high school students explore caves and learn about the importance of cave ecology. Check it out.
Buffalo National River. We're in northwest Arkansas. We're here for Project C.A.V.E.S. It's a week-long course where we're teaching the series of geology and cave ecology for students, and they're from all throughout the state of Arkansas.
It stands for Creative Adventures and Valuable Experiences in Spelunking. We'll be taking the kids out and letting them actually explore some wild caves, some guided wild caves, and then we'll also be taking them to some commercial caves so that they get a good overview of the different types of caves that exist, that are out there. We'll also be taking the kids on some geological hikes so that they understand better how the geology of this area formed.
Camps are kind of in a, I would say, classroom setting, you know, a lot of PowerPoints, that kind of stuff. I wanted something really hands-on. I wanted to get dirty. I wanted to, like, see how it's really done in Arkansas.
Project C.A.V.E.S gets you dirty, and I like it.
Science in a classroom and science in a book is very different from science in real life. And we really want kids to understand what goes into geological research. What is it that geologists do to understand how these caves formed? And then also the biology of what's in the cave, not just in a textbook sense, but how this knowledge is actually formed.
Education like this really gets information into people's heads, not only in their heads, but in their hearts, and they'll never forget the experiences they have and the friendships they make to the people that have interests like them.
Classroom environments where you lay down the basic understanding. But when you come to a place like Buffalo River and you explore the wondrous caves and formations that we have here, that environment brings out the classroom education in such a way that it provides context and meaning.
Part of it is social and emotional connections with kids from across the state. A lot of it is science-based academic enrichment, and it's about getting bright kids together and having good learning opportunities for them.
Seeing the kids work together is always an instantaneous highlight. I love seeing that. That comes out almost immediately. But long term, I love seeing how these camps affect their future decisions. They affect how they think about science.
I actually attended Project C.A.V.E.S about 20-something years ago when I was a kid. It definitely changed my life. And hopefully it will these kids.
The cave yesterday was kind of hard, but I liked the experience that it brought and being gathered as a team, so that was really cool.
Getting to basically just jump around in mud and get completely covered was just super fun.
The amount of freedom we got in that cave to just explore was really gratifying. There's mud everywhere, just slipping constantly, and I was covered in mud by the end, and it was pretty great. That's the highlight so far.
It's very important that we make these new level of conservationists to where they understand the natural world and why it's important to preserve that world for their own quality of living.
Above and beyond book learning, although there's a little book learning involved, there's a lot more of it is practical, hands-on, and sometimes it's hard to offer those kind of opportunities in a school setting, but not in the summer at the national park.
Project C.A.V.E.S.
And what a great partnership it is with the national parks. Thanks for watching Outside Science, Inside Parks. Join us next month when we travel to Alaska to check out how whales communicate.